On February 23, 2022, the alert level at a dangerous volcano in Japan was raised from green to yellow by government scientists, corresponding to a change from level 1 to 2 in the local 5-level alert system. The volcano in question is known as Mount Ontake, which has a history of powerful phreatic explosive eruptions that form craters in the ground known as Mars. Mount Ontake is most famous for its 2014 phreatic eruption, which not only was its largest on record, but also occurred without warning. In that eruption, a series of northwest-trending vents on the southern flank of the volcano erupted, producing pyroclastic flows which burned everything up to 3 kilometers distant. This eruption was quite deadly, as dozens of hikers were on the volcano when it erupted, primarily on its summit. As shown by this aforementioned eruption, it is rare that we see warning signs of an eruption ahead of time, as the hydrothermal system which triggers phreatic eruptions is quite shallow. Wednesday's increase in alert level was done in response to a series of 80 volcanic earthquakes and harmonic tremor events directly underneath Mount Ontake's edifice. These earthquakes occurred in the span of an hour from 2 to 3 p.m. local time, most likely signaling a sudden increased temperature and movement of underlying heated groundwater. The fear is that given enough time, a portion of the underlying groundwater will be heated by magma beneath the volcano and eventually flash to steam. This would cause an immense amount of pressure to build, as steam takes up a greater space than the same volume of liquid water. Eventually, an explosion might burst through the surface in what is termed a phreatic eruption, much like what occurred in 2014. The aforementioned earthquakes occurred alongside a minor amount of uplift on Ontake's highest peak, which just happens to be adjacent to the site of its most recent eruptions. While the Mount Ontake volcanic complex exists over a wide area and has been active intermittently for 780,000 years, all of its recent eruptions have occurred on the south to southwest flank of the volcano. Since 1979, 4 such phreatic eruptions have occurred. While the larger eruptions, such as what occurred in 1979 and 2014, built a chain of craters, the smaller eruptions instead occurred from a single vent. Although a new volcanic eruption could technically occur elsewhere in the volcano, it is most likely to originate in the same area. As a result, a near-crater warning was issued, meaning that people are not allowed to be within 1 kilometer or 3,280 feet of any of its craters due to the threat of pyroclastic flows and flying boulders of rock which would be ejected during any explosion. However, I believe that this warning is insufficient given the topography of Mount Ontake. If an eruption were to occur, it could create pyroclastic flows that travel up to 5 kilometers away. These pyroclastic flows, for the most part, would be funneled into a river channel labeled on screen, so people should avoid these channels up to a distance of 10 kilometers. Third, such an eruption would generate acidic lahars in these river channels, which could be voluminous enough to destroy several local bridges. Of course, a new volcanic eruption by any means is still not a certainty. Increased periods of seismic activity and uplift do not result in eruptions the vast majority of the time. Since this volcano is very seismically active, it is rare that scientists truly see several warning signs all point towards an eruption at the same time. This near-crater warning could potentially last for months, so do not travel to this volcano while the near-crater warning remains. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Crimson Skullcracker, for supporting this channel.